Hello, athletes. I am Dylan.
I'm Chase.
And together we are jamming with MJ.
So today for our activities, you'll need a couple of items and objects to get ready. You'll need either a trash can, a laundry basket, a box, or a sink. Something with a hole to toss a ball in. For the ball, you can use a ball, paper ball, wadded up, some socks, old socks, any kind of round object you can toss in. And then you'll need a couple markers to mark your distance. So you can use cups, cones, pencils, rags, anything really. That's all the equipment and some water too for between our activities to get hydrated.
So now we're gonna start with our warm-up. We're gonna first start out with jumping jacks. You're gonna have your feet together, arms at your side, and then raising your arms and your feet. Here we go, we're gonna do five of them. One, two, three, four, five. Okay, so after that, we're gonna do toe touches. You're gonna have your feet together, and you're just gonna try to touch your toes for 5 seconds. One, two, three, four, five.
Next, we'll have air squats. So you're gonna have your feet about shoulder width apart, and you're gonna go down as far as you can, and then back up. If you can't go all the way down, you can actually take a chair and sit in the chair and go back up. If that's too much, we're gonna do five of them. So nice and slow down and then back up. So one, two, three, four, five. All right. And the last warm-up exercise is a little vertical jump up. So you're just gonna take your feet again, shoulder width apart, and bend down, and just jump as high as you can up. And if you wanna just have it as high as you can, or if you wanna stay low, just do as best you can. So we're gonna do five of those. All right. One, two, three, four, five.
Okay, the last thing is we're gonna run in place for 5 seconds as fast as we can. Ready, go. One, two, three, four, five. Okay. So now we're gonna set up for our activity. You're gonna need to make balls, which we did, out of socks. And for markers to place your
distance,
we're gonna use pencils. You can use really anything, bottles, shoes, anything you want. And then this is gonna be our basket for today's activity. We're gonna set that right here. We're gonna set it about five steps from the goal. And if you can do 10, 15, 20, go for it. So for this activity, we're gonna set a timer for 90 seconds. And if you have a partner, you can have them as a backboard. If you have a wall, you can use your backboard. So in this example, Chase is gonna be the backboard. And you're gonna set your clock for 90 seconds. And you're gonna toss it in. And first you're gonna practice which one you want, which is an overhand, which is a step, low, and make a low third of your target.
And then the other hand one, if you don't want the overhand, you're gonna kinda just take the ball, move it back past your back, and just lean with it forward and follow through and just let it roll out of your hand. But whatever feels more comfortable to you, just go with that.
Whatever one you feel you want to do, that is up to you. So for this, we're gonna set a timer for 90 seconds. You're gonna toss it and you're gonna run back, grab it, and come back to the line that you choose. Just keep doing that for 90 seconds. Ready, and go.
There we go. Yeah.
Oh no.
That's too easy. If you keep making it really easily, go ahead and take your 5 steps back and try it from a further distance.
Yeah, if you're able to, get some more distance. Just find ways to make it more difficult.
Yeah, I need it to be more difficult. And make sure you're not handing the ball back so they can get a better exercise and run after it themselves.
Yeah.
You're just here for the backboard. To stop the ball from falling back. I hope you get it in. You need the backboard.
main goal is to be running as much as you can while trying to make it into the basket.
About 15 seconds.
I'm on a roll now.
That's it.
Time's up.
20 seconds. And then after that, you're going to take a little water break. So grab your water. You cool off for a little bit. And then after you get cooled down, you get a little rest and some water in you, you're going to go for your second round of 90 seconds. So in this case, we're going to switch now. I'm going to do it. All right. So when you're ready, get your timer up. And ready, set, go.
Goal!
And that was underhand, so try a little bit of overhand.
Do that.
You can use the backboard.
We've got about 30 seconds now. So keep going for as many as you can. Time's up for this activity. So for the last little bit, we're going to walk through some dances. Well, since we're MJ, we're going to show you some dance moves.
Yep. So if you have some music to play, or we're going to play some Billie Jean, some Michael Jackson. And so first kind of moves we're going to learn is a moonwalk. So this one can be a little tricky, but if you want to start, you're gonna face the wall. You can take off your socks if you want to, or your shoes. Make it a little bit more slippery and easy for you. And you're gonna face this way. You're gonna put your left foot forward and your right foot back, and have that one up. And you're gonna slide your left foot back like that. Just practice sliding it back. And then when you get back, you're gonna shift that foot and the weight and make it look up like that. It's kind of confusing at first, but you just go like that, and you're gonna switch that one up, that one down, like that, switch it. And then when you get into that a little bit more, you're gonna go back and switch, and switch, and switch, and switch, like that. Shifting your weight, so it looks something like that. All right, and then once you practice that one a little bit, we're gonna do a little spin, and it's pretty much staying forward, spin, twist, and back to the front. So if that's too easy, you can try a double or whatever you want to do. But just kind of take your weight and you want to throw it all to the left and just spin it off and kind of hop a little bit. Get that momentum going. And then, Dylan, we're going to throw a little thriller.
A little
arm movements. So for the thriller, you're going to start with your hands right here. You're going to go up to your left. Just practice going like this. Kind of like you're a dinosaur, a T-Rex, going like that, and look to the way you look, move your hands. So then you're gonna go left, and you're gonna walk to the left. And you're gonna go right, left, right. And then go the other way, right?
About two steps each way.
Yeah. So then when you get that, you'll be just going that way, that way, that way, and just walk and just have fun doing it. And then we're gonna put all these together at the end, but the last thing, if you wanna try something a little bit more difficult, but it's fun, you can use a wall, put your hands behind the wall to support yourself. But after you do the spin, you can try to go up on your toes like that. So if you want to hold onto a wall or get a partner like this, I'm using Dylan just to put my weight on him like that. So now we're gonna play some Billie Jean. We're gonna put all the moves together and have a little dance party thing right here.
Be free to do whatever moves you want to as
yeah.
well. You don't feel comfortable doing these, just have some fun.
Yeah.
Get a little dancing in.
Yeah. All right, so we're getting some music going. All right, we're gonna start off with the thriller.
Thriller,
yeah, let's go.
Here's the left first.
Yep.
Here we go.
Let's have fun doing it. Now we're going to the moonwalk. Over here, go back, do a little spin, bang, like that. Throw it all together, just have fun, do some more spins. Practice that moonwalk, have fun sliding around.
Yeah.
There we go. Practice your day moves, have some fun. Yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching. Jam with MJ.